In this video tutorial, we're going to demonstrate how to use the TauDEM processing tools on OpenTopography and visualize the products in QGIS. TauDEM, Terrain Analysis Using Digital Elevation Models, are a suite of tools used to extract and analyze hydrologic information from digital elevation models, or DEMs. To use TauDEM tools on OpenTopography, you must be registered for a free OpenTopography account. You can go to My OpenTopo to log into an existing account or register for a new free account. To download data and access processing tools, go to Data and Find Data Map. Zoom in on the map and navigate to your area of interest. Here, we'll be using a dataset from the San Gabriel Mountains. Click the Select a Region box and draw a box around your area of interest. TauDEM tools are available both for point cloud and raster datasets. Raster datasets will allow you to select a larger area, and point clouds will allow you to change the resolution of the DEM and the derived products. If using a point cloud, click on that option. You can further refine your selected area if desired. We suggest that the area you select includes the full headwater region of the catchment. Otherwise, part of the data products may result in no data due to edge contamination. After selecting your region, make sure only the ground classification is selected. Select the type of point cloud data download, and then make sure DEM generation is selected. Here, you can change the DEM resolution if desired. I'm going to downgrade the grid resolution to 10 meters so that it's easier to visualize the final products in this tutorial. If desired, you can select to generate additional derivative or visualization products. Then under the TauDEM selection, choose the products you would like to generate. For all TauDEM products, you must select hydrologically correct DEM with pits filled. This will identify pits or low points in the DEM and fill them so that there is a hydrologically continuous and connected surface. You can choose either or both the D8 or D-infinity methods for calculating flow direction. D8 encodes flow direction as a value 1 through 8, with numbers going counterclockwise from east and each value corresponding to a direction. D-infinity flow direction is encoded as an angle in radians counterclockwise from east. Both flow direction calculations will also produce a separate slope map file. You can then select the corresponding D8 or D-infinity contributing area. If calculating using D-infinity, you can also produce a topographic wetness index. Under job description, you can include a job title and description. Your email will automatically be filled in when you are logged into your account. Click Submit to run the job. You will be notified via email when the job is finished, so you do not need to leave this page open while the job is processing, as it will take a few minutes to finish running. Now, if using raster data for TauDEM, make sure that only Digital Terrain Model is selected under Layer Types. The TauDEM products will show the same selections as with Point Cloud. When the job has finished, you can click to download each of the TauDEM products. Once you have your downloaded products, they will need to be extracted and unzipped. We will be opening these files and visualizing them using QGIS, which is free to download and use. Open QGIS and begin a new project. We're first going to demonstrate and use the D8 products, as this is the simplest method for visualizing flow direction. Select the DEM, flow direction, and contributing area files, dragging and dropping them into our QGIS project. Drag the files to reorder them so that from bottom to top they are your DEM, flow direction, and contributing area layers. Uncheck the boxes to make only the DEM layer visible. We are first going to quickly visualize it as a hillshade. Right-click on the layer, select Properties, and under Symbology, change the render type to hillshade. then click OK. Next, turn on the visibility for the flow direction layer. Again, with D8, this layer is encoded with values 1 through 8, each representing a corresponding direction the water would flow across the terrain. Right-click on this layer and select Properties. Under Symbology, change the render type to paletted/unique values. Click the Classify button. It will populate values 1 through 8 with randomly assigned colors. Here we want to add a continuous color ramp, so click on the color ramp bar and choose a color ramp. Here we'll be using spectral. Click OK. You can leave this layer as is, or you can further adjust the symbology. Since values 8, 1, and 2 are adjacent to each other, we can make a more continuous color ramp. We're going to go back to our color ramp symbology, selecting the color ramp and going to Edit Color Ramp. Click on the color dropper to adjust the color. I'm going to make this a rainbow color scheme so that value 8 in blue will be more continuous with value 1, now in purple. Click OK when finished adjusting the colors. Next, we can rename the labels to the corresponding flow direction. Double-click on the text to edit and type in the corresponding labels, east, northeast, north, etc. Click OK to apply changes. Now we have a fully visualized and labeled flow direction layer that shows what direction water would flow across the terrain. Then we want to turn on the visibility of the contributing area layer and turn off our other layers. Contributing area is much easier to visualize when we take the log of the layer. In the top menu, go to Raster and Raster Calculator. We're going to perform a calculation that will take the log of this layer. Under Operators, select log 10, which will populate in the expression box. Under Raster Bands, double-click on your contributing area layer. Close your parentheses. At the top under Output Layer, click on the dots to browse where you would like to save your file and give it a name. Then select OK. The layer now is much easier to visualize. We're now going to adjust the symbology of the layer. Right-click on the layer, select Properties, and in the Symbology window, change the render type to Single Band Pseudo Color. Go to the color ramp bar and select a ramp like plasma. We're then going to invert the color ramp so that the blue colors represent higher contributing areas. Select OK. This visualization shows the whole landscape with the hill slopes as a channel network, but we just want to visualize the mainstream network itself. For this, we choose an arbitrary threshold area that will dictate the density of the channel network shown. Go back to Raster and Raster Calculator. Double-click on your log layer of contributing area. Add the division symbol, then begin parentheses and double-click on your log layer again. Click to put in the greater than or equal to operator. Now we put in our threshold value. I've chosen 3.5. Remember that this value represents an area of 10 to the 3.5 as we took the log of this layer. Close your parentheses. This calculation is set to only return values that are greater than or equal to a contributing area of 3.5. If the value is less than 3.5, the division will be undefined and will exclude those values. At the top under Output Layer, click on the dots to browse where you would like to save your file and give it a name. Click OK. Then turn off the visibility of any other layers below. Now we have visualized just the mainstream network. If you choose a smaller threshold value, the network will appear more dense, and if you choose a higher threshold area, it will be less dense. We can finish by adjusting the symbology of this layer. Open your symbology again, change the render type to single band pseudo color. We're going to set the same color ramp, plasma, and reverse the color so that blue again represents a higher contributing area. You can turn on your original DEM layer to see how the stream network looks on the landscape. You can also open an OpenStreetMap layer and compare the TauDEM product that is fully derived from the topography with the mapped rivers. Now, if using the D-Infinity products, the workflow is generally the same. For setting the symbology of D-Infinity flow direction, choose single band pseudo color as the render type and select a color ramp. The values of D-Infinity flow direction are encoded as angles in radians counterclockwise from east, so there are not discrete direction categories to label. The contributing area follows the same workflow as D8, except you may have to choose a slightly different and higher threshold contributing area for the same DEM region. For more video tutorials like this, you can find more on the Open Topography YouTube channel or at opentopography.org.